in a very unstable time, a time of great uncertainty, therefore a time of huge vulnerability. Now, this may seem like a terrible state of affairs. We're anxious about our health, we're anxious about what the future holds. But curiously, I would argue this vulnerability we're experiencing is also an opportunity. So music, which is, if you like, a perfect mirror to humankind, it's the most universal language we have, way beyond any dialect or tongue. Music holds a mirror up to all of us, every inhabitant of planet Earth. And it's all about the delicious and exquisitely painful dance between dissonance and consonance. You can't have true joyous consonance without some dissonance. You can't have certainty without investing in your vulnerability. This is absolutely key in music, and in this exquisite prelude by J.S. Bach, I think it explicates perfectly what I'm talking about. The delicious pain of dissonance and how it's constantly dragging us away from where we want to be, our comfort zone, our home point, our continuation in life in a congruent fashion. So look at this bit here. It's already a slightly unstable chord because that would be home, that would be consonant, but it's that. And that goes to an even darker chord. Ooh, feel the pain in that. Still more pain. But we know that the light is just around the corner because of this chord. It's not home yet, you see, because it's got an unstable bottom. If it was home, it would be that. Can you hear the difference? Unstable, stable. So you've got... It's playing with us. So near to home, but not quite yet. So far, in a way. And another disease chord. Oh, the agony, the sweet agony of that. Nearly but not quite home. Ah, we feel we're getting somewhere now. Where's this chord leading us? Nearly home, but that note you can hear if it was. It would be home. Lovely bass chord. That puts a seed of doubt. Solace, resolution.